Hey YouTube, welcome to another 3D Thursday. We're gonna change up the format a little bit, and instead of doing a weekly episode of 3D printed items, we're gonna do a monthly cap of what we printed in that month. And I'm still not gonna notify subscribers because I don't want to scare away the subscribers that I do have that aren't interested in 3D printing. So if you're interested in them, just occasionally check my channel and see if there's a new video up. So we've got two items over here at the mill that I'll show you, and then one over at the toolbox. And they're not real super exciting, innovative stuff, but there's a little bit of cool things involved with them. So stick around and we'll check them out. So the first thing is this R8 Collet Rack. And yeah, R8 Collet Rack's not that exciting, but I custom made it to fit in this tray, and these trays are some sort of tray that came out of a clothing store or something like that. They were thrown away and they fit in this pegboard. But I'll dump these collets out and flip it over and show you why it's kind of cool. I did on this is I hate printing supports, and I hate printing upside down because, the supports leave an ugly finish and all that stuff. So what I did is I tapered this all up, and so it would be able to print without any support. And I think it came out pretty good other than the sucking up from the bed, but I didn't want to start it over. So yep, just a simple R8 collet rack. And so I got some of this 2.5 inch Loc-Line for dust collection on the router. And I haven't used it yet. I haven't set it all up, but I wanted something that I could, utilize it now. And I had printed a test piece, and it's not perfect, but this was actually the first thing I ever modeled up in Fusion 360. I had been using Sketchup before, and Sketchup's really simple, but it lags a lot when you download the extension that allows you to export it for a 3D printer. So anyways, it's not perfect, but the fit worked well. And the main thing was is I wanted to model a link up so I could make accessories for it. And I had came up with a female side for plugging in the vacuum hose, and then an outlet so I could pop the line on. And these are magnets. You could find these laying all over alongside the road. There's usually an orange flag attached to them, and when they're hauling heavy equipment, they'll put these flags on the heavy equipment. And so whenever I see an orange flag on the side of the highway, I pull over and I pick up these magnets. So anyways, I could put this on the mill or the router table or whatever, and plug my vacuum into it and have some dust collection. So I recently was given a Ziploc bag full of new but slightly rusty machinist length drill bits, and there's a couple sizes missing, but they're to 1/2 inch and 1/64. And I wanted to nicely organize them, so I 3D printed these trays. There's six, each one is 6 by 7. My 3D printer won't go anything above 7, otherwise I'd print them to 7.25. And I was going to 3D print different pieces that clip on here that indicate what size is in what tray, and that way I can use the same trays for taps and dies or letter drills or whatever. And what initially set me off in this path was I saw someone 3D printing trays, but I had purchased a bunch of the shaller bins, and using their drawer layout on their website, this is how it ended up. And I knew they were a little bit shy, but I didn't pay attention when I was ordering them, and they're a little bit looser than I was hoping for. So I'm pretty happy with the way this turned out. And my theory behind this was I was custom fit them to the drill bits. Their width for two drill bits plus a tenth, and until a certain width. I can't remember what I had the certain width, but I didn't want to get any smaller than this. And it just so happened that the sterret box fits in there perfectly too. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.